This week's Ask Dr. Dury question comes from someone who has a very reasonable question. They say that they have heard the results from the IFM French trial that were presented at ASH, but the results are kind of confusing, and can I explain? And so I think that the truth of the matter is that at this point in time, the results are a bit confusing. In this trial, called the IFM 2009 trial, which is when the trial started, the patients received Velcade, Revlimid, and Dex with or without a transplant, an autologous stem cell transplant, in the frontline setting. And so the confusing part is that although patients had a longer remission with the VRD plus the transplant, the overall survival at the present time is equal. In other words, there doesn't seem to be a benefit with the added transplant. However, at ASH, the presenter indicated, and this was Dr. Hervé Abbott-Lousseau, the key investigator who looked at the measurement of minimal residual disease in this trial, he noted that patients who achieved minimal residual disease negative did better, and this was at the 1 in a million level in the bone marrow. So patients with no myeloma in the bone marrow out of 1 in a million cells, those patients did better, and also that there were more patients in that category in the transplant group versus the non-transplant group. He also showed that those patients really did better. He also showed that if patients with VRD only achieved that MRD negative status, they did well, just as well actually, as the patients who were MRD negative with the transplant. And so, as mentioned by this questioner, this was pretty confusing to everyone. And so, what is the bottom line here? Well, the bottom line is that we do suspect that since there are more patients achieving that deep level of response, the 10 to the minus 6 level negative, in the transplant group, then ultimately those patients will have a better survival. And so if we look at other trials for comparison, for example, a trial which I conducted through the Southwest Oncology Group, the 777 trial, which compared Velcade, Revlimid, and Dex versus Revlimid Dex, it actually took almost 10 years of follow-up to show that the VRD patients had a 1 year better survival versus the doublet Revlimid and Dex. And so one idea is that with longer follow-up, we will indeed see that the transplanted patients do have longer survival. However, the other idea which many people are concerned about is that since we do have excellent backup treatments right now, and these backup treatments would be offered to all the patients, it may be confusing, and we may never actually be able to see if there is a survival benefit out at 5 and 10 years in the transplanted patients. And so because of this, the French group, the IFM, are already starting another trial which will try to clarify this and really show for sure if transplant does add in the setting of where VRD is continued to try to achieve a maximum response with the VRD without the added transplant. So a confusing point, but my own feeling is that there is value with the transplant, and with longer follow-up, we will hopefully be able to demonstrate that.